Hello, everyone, and welcome to the Methods and Techniques series. We haven't been back here in a while. We're going to go revisit this series here because today I'm going to try and explain how I build Scrappy. In this particular series, this is vanilla, of course, all DLC, no mods. And lately, I've been getting a lot of comments, questions, inquiries. You know, hey, how did you do this? How did you do that? How do you do this? And I thought maybe it'd be valuable to show you guys three different buildings that I built from scratch. I mean, I literally had no conception of what I was going to do. So during this thing, we're going to build three different things. One is going to be going into the back of a hill. One's going to be going on the side of a hill. And then one's going to be on the rocks over there behind the buildings of Zimonja. So what I'm going to try to do while you're watching this is kind of explain like the theories behind it, like the mindset, the process. Maybe it'll help, you know, when you want to build Scrappy, to visualize and apply your style to these kinds of methods. Okay, so I've touched on this stuff in the past, so I'll probably cover it again if I remember, because I don't script this stuff. I just kind of watch it. But the thing is that the main things to think about are mixing materials and weird angles, you know, not snapping. Now here I'm snapping because I'm kind of in a hurry, but in this thing here, you can see already that I've got wood, metal, scaffolding. I've got, I'm going to put other, like a junk fence on here. There's going to be all kinds of stuff. But it's mostly wood, because when I build Scrappy, most of the pieces, the other pieces that are not wood, you don't have a wide enough variety. Most of them are clean, or they're too regular, or they're too whatever. And also when you build Scrappy is you basically toss stuff up where it goes, pop, drop it, and like, okay, that's good. Ding, good enough. Like this roof here. It's off to the side. It does not snap to nothing. It's a warehouse piece, and it's not even metal or wood. I'm thinking, do I need to support this? I don't know. Maybe. Another thing you'll find a lot when you build Scrappy is that you'll undo stuff quite a bit. In that, like here, I'm going to put a wall on the inside, right? And I'm like, how do I want to do this? Do I want to do that? Do I want to do this? I need to be able to snap a wall to this. So, because I saw the wall snap to the metal piece before. So I'm like, hey, will this work? Okay, it won't work like that. Okay, so if it's up like that, it won't work. So now we take the stuff back out, right? And in the previous Methods and Techniques series, I did a lot of build order stuff, which you're seeing a lot here, right? I'm using those little floors for spacing, to hold things. You put the floor in, you snap stuff to it, you take the floor back out. Now see here, now that I've got that wall in there, the ladder bolt snaps. So I'm like, okay, well, I'll just move the ladder over to the next spot. Good, done. And that's good enough. Now there's the whole building for the most part, right? The basic part of the building. These shacks are basically gonna be housing for two people. They're gonna be two settler shacks. Now, when I put things in the wall, when I sink things in the ground, I always like to leave a little bit of dirt showing through. Not enough to obstruct walking, because that's the thing. If you can't path through it, like if the ground's too tall and the roof's too small, if you can't get to it, the settlers won't walk up it. And you're going to see the pathing problem when I stick this junk wall in, because what I didn't realize is the bounding box on the top of the junk wall is a little higher than I would have expected. But again, problem solving. So here I'm like, okay, I've got the thing elevated. I need a foundation. I need something to block off the ground. So I'm gonna use a junk wall. But of course I got the rug on backwards because I need to put the thing in with it bending in rather than out. So I raise it up like I always do, flip it around, and look at that. It actually sticks in way in there. So we're gonna do that. So when you build Scrappy, I guess the key takeaways for the most part are leave it where you dropped it, unless it literally does not work. Like you can't walk up it or you can't path over it or whatever. See, like this, that looks really cool, right? Kind of sticking out some ragged, you know, looking boards that you really can't get any other way. And there's a tip I wanted to tell you all about too. You know, when you take the rug out and sometimes the walls jump, they'll go up, they'll go down, whatever, you never can tell. What I've been learning as a walk around is if you pick the wall up and drop it, you know, don't set it, just pick it up and drop it. Like, you know, when you normally set something that's vibrating, when you take the rug out, most of the time it does not move. It's like when you set it down the second time on its own, it's fine. It's only when you place it on the rug with the pillar that it does strange things. So give that a shot. If you want a junk wall or a sunk wall, or something you rug to stay put, pick the item up and drop it before you take the rug out. At least it works with junk fences. I don't know if it works with furniture or not. So we've got that there. That looks pretty good. We got the side thing done. Good. Now we're going to take this thing and, you know, rails out. I like rails out on this. Just drop it in there and just leave it. You know, it's like, okay, looking pretty good. Now we need to place some beds because I am going to furnish these. And I go up and I'm like, I can't get up. Why can't I get up? This is very strange. Ah, I'll worry about it later. So here's one bedroom. And then we're going to stick the other one just right here because both of them are under roofs and they will count for your happiness. They'll be fine. Put an observation chair here, and then we'll give them a dining room chair. We'll give them a table and another chair. And then, you know, maybe a lantern, maybe some candles, whatever. But this is just like the basic setup that you can do in, what, 10, 15 minutes, right? This whole thing was built in like 15 minutes. I'm not liking that thing, though. I don't like that I can't get up the stairs. So now we get the rug back out. I'm going to put this back on there. What else? What other tips we got here? Because, I mean, there's all these concept things that I want to try and describe so that when you do this, when you try this on your own, it makes sense, but you use your own style, you know, because it's like, it's a junk house. I mean, really, you don't really need to copy somebody else's junk house. The whole point is it's junk, right? It's a crab shack. See, it still can't get up. So I'm going to move it again, push it in a little bit further, lower it a little bit more, go up, still can't get in. And now it's too close to the ladder, so when I pick it up, the whole thing jumps. So you move the pillar out just to grab the rug, and there we go. So now what I do is I lower it and I slide it a little bit further, right? Yeah, see, because it's sticking out, right? It's under that ladder. But yeah, this is the experimentation that you get. But there it is, and there it is. And it looks a little bit better now, right? I mean, it's not flush. It's got a little overhang, but I don't know. The overhang is kind of convincing. So, okay, there's our first house. It's, there you go. It's wood and steel and concrete and scaffolding and warehouse and junk fence and beds and, you know, stuff. And then you can dress it up, decorate it, put shelves in, whatever. Now, the second build we're going to do is we're going to use the concrete pillar and the scaffolding. I am starting to really like using scaffolding as my sinking tool. One reason is because it's thinner. Right here I am looking at it, right? I'm looking at the hill going, okay, how am I going to build this? Okay, I'm going to need a stairway, so let's go ahead and lay down the stairs first. When you do these things, there's two main ways to do it. You can go from the top down, or you can go from the bottom up. In this particular case, I'm going to go from the bottom up because usually I go from the top down. I usually build the, well, I'm going to go from the top down, aren't I? I totally forgot. So, scaffolding. Scaffolding's thinner, it sinks really, really well. And the thing about scaffolding that's really nice is it's taller than the concrete pillar. And it's got a bigger clip range than the steel pillar and the wood pillar from the wood supports from barn and warehouse. So the scaffolding can give you a lot of flexibility if you want to place, like I use it a lot for placing roofs. Because, of course, the roof is going to be on top of a concrete pillar height structure. And being able to put it with the scaffolding helps a lot. Gives me a little bit of extra range. So, okay, now I'm going to build from the top down. I got my stairway. I'm going to do the stairs on this side. Will this snap? A lot of experimentation here as well. When it comes to supports, you just saw me use those marble ball tracks things. I am really starting to like those things. They sink really good. They clip really good. They're very flexible and versatile. I could wish there were a marble that had just a single post. Or that had the two posts with a crossbar like you see under bridges in Bethesda's building stuff. So, but that's okay. They look good. You place them, you know, at an angle in the corner. Looks like the corner supports. Get up on the top. Let's build a stairway. Now we're going to build a stairway down. Building stairways down is always trickier. Because if you build stairways up, it's easier to get the height right and the sinking right. But if you go top to bottom, it's easier to build a building, but if you go bottom to top, it's easier to build stairs. I think I said that right. So I'm going to do my, you know, group select, different angles. Again, don't square things up. Try not to be symmetrical. Try to put it a little bit off center, a little bit lower, a little bit higher. But, you know, make sure it looks structurally supported like this thing does. And that's not going to work. That thing's hanging off like it's not going to work. So let's go ahead and try a ladder. Stairs. Let's try different stairs here. Concrete, yeah, concrete ain't feeling it. But again, as you watch this, you see as I change materials, I'm constantly thinking, okay, what am I going to use that is not wood? What am I going to use that is not warehouse? Is there something in here I can use? Something there I can use? What's going to happen here? Because, I mean, it makes sense because the settlers don't have access to, you know, perfect things all the time. They use what they can get their hands on. And by randomizing or, you know, moving around on the tabs, you can get the effect of that happening. So, okay, this ain't gonna work, right? I'm like, okay, I need those stairs to touch the ground, but also be under those stairs, the stairs above it, the metal stairs, and it ain't gonna happen. It's just, it's not gonna work. The height's wrong. That angle's not gonna work. That's just not doing it. So let's get rid of it, scrap it, and get the big one. But again, we're gonna solve a problem here because the big one doesn't snap because it's buried too far in the ground or the ground underneath is too weird or whatever. Here's a trick. Group select it with the pillar and it'll go in. It'll use the pillar's clipping instead of the other thing. So, okay, there's that. So now we've got a shell of a house. What am I gonna do? Am I gonna go flat walls? Am I gonna go metal walls? Okay, so I'm gonna pick a metal wall. Pick this one. I like this metal wall a lot. That rough, jagged thing. It's hard to place sometimes, but I love the back of it because the back of it looks really convincing as a scrap thing. Now that shack wall right there with the flat roof, I don't use this thing very much because I don't like the flat roof. But in this case, I need something different, and that's different. We got that in. I'm like, okay, am I going to go flat wall? We got the approach. Where's the door going to be? How are they going to get in? And of course, the logic part is, if that's going to be the entrance, I need to block off the top to make it make sense that it's the only entrance, right? So nothing will snap. Can't get it to do. This thing's in the way now. And I'm like, pick it up. Won't reset. Okay, so I need to make an executive decision. How am I going to fix that hole? Well, let's go ahead and grab another shack wall and then just group select it into the side of the thing, right? Because that should work. Group selecting at weird angles is the biggest tool, the most effective tool you can use to make scrappy. It really is, because as long as you don't get too fussy about trying to line things up, you know, when you lose your snapping, like this thing here, watch when it comes up, there's a big crack. It's like, okay, well, whatever. It's got a crack in it. It's sunk into the hill, lift it up, fine. It's at a different angle. It's at a different height. Looks weird, but that's good enough. And now there's two ways in, right? There's this corner and the other corner. So now I'm gonna stick a roof on it, reach for metal because I've been using too much wood. But I'm not liking the look of this. I want it to snap to that one I just placed, the crooked one, because I'd love to stick over crooked, but there's too many other surfaces for it to cling to inside, so it won't snap, even though I think it just did. But I don't like it. It's too low. It doesn't look right. I need something a little bit beefier. Let's get this chunky thing out. Yeah, there we go. Another tip, that particular roof is excellent for patching elevation gaps because it's so huge on the one side. Even if your other wall is like, I don't know, 2 feet higher, it'll still butt up against that roof on the tall end. So you can snap it in and still get it to look right. And of course the sleeping bags and the table and the candle and another kitchen table so they can eat, whatever. But this is just your random scrappy shack. My kitchen table? Yeah, kitchen table. And then, of course, my favorite chairs, the green regular kitchen chair. Yep. And then the folding metal chair. I wish I could get flat metal folding chairs in vanilla, just to have them, like, stacked up against the wall. Give them a little decoration, a little carpet. So now they have two entrances, and I don't like that. And I don't like the fact that this thing's kind of floating. So let's go ahead and go in back to our ball track and slap that thing in there. Apologies for the rain. I'm not running mod, so I don't get clear weather. I hope you can see this okay. But yeah, this is shaping up. It's a little funky. This one's a little bit too regular, I think, in terms of snapping. There's a lot of snapping going on. And this particular metal wall here, I use this metal wall too much, but I love it so much. It's such a cool space filler because it's round and it's full and it's just, I don't know, it's cool. So we sink that in there and we look around. We're like, okay, and there's a gap in the wall. Is there a gap in the wall? Yeah. How am I gonna patch that? What am I going to reach for? I need something that's that wide. I could use the metal pillar. You know, I could use the warehouse pillar, but I'm going to go ahead and try this wall, the barn wall, because I haven't used the barn wall yet. So we go ahead and grab the barn tab and stick this thing in, try and get a good visual. Can't really see where it is. And we stick it in as best we can. Now, if I were to have fixed this later, I probably would have tried to add like a platform on the edge of this, like snap a floor to this thing to hang over the shack, but it's good enough. And so there we go. Here is another two resident raggedy thing kind of hanging off the hill. And you can path into it, because as you can see, I can walk all the way down the hill. They can get to their beds, they can get up the stairs, and that's it. So now number three is gonna be a side hill. Now you can see between these things, those houses disappeared because I literally built them and scrapped them. I took them down. The reason for that is when I have pieces that I've already used in my menus, I tend to gravitate towards those. And I don't want to reuse them because the whole point of this is to build random, or as random as I can get as I select things. Now this thing here is inspired by the guard hut at County Crossing. You know, basically I call this the scissors. This is the scissors building because it's got that acute angle, you know, less than 90 degrees. Actually, this is like less than 45, like 30 degrees here. But again, I'm wedging it as close as I can. I'm changing the height a little bit because I don't want them all to be the same level if I can avoid it. And, okay, so there's our basic. So we're going to put, you know, you could put two beds on there, whatever. I need to patch the hole in the back. So that's what you basically do when you build Scrappy, too. Another theory thing is you create sloppy things that you need to fix, right? You create stuff that doesn't work, but you have to make it work. And instead of pulling it down and making it pretty, you just keep throwing new pieces at it. Now I'm like, okay, that gap in the middle, I need a floor for it. Oh, look, things will snap because the right-hand wall is high up enough over the left-hand one that I can snap to it. I look at this, I'm like, yeah, that looks kind of cool. It sticks out the back, but who cares? I'll just bury that. But I'm like, you know, maybe not. I'm not really feeling that. Let me try wood floors. Let me see how wood floors look. Oh, that's much better. That looks way better. Okay, yeah, get rid of that concrete floor. So now here's our shack. And we're going to dress it up. We're going to give them a balcony because I don't like using, I prefer not to use snappy things on the thick wall there, the gap, you know, the half walls will snap to. So I stick that up there and I'm like, okay, that's decent. And then we put a roof on it. Oh, look at that. It snapped and it sticks out weird. Score. So here's our house. Now we're going to stick it on the side of the hill. And we're going to drop it. I'm not going to elevate like the other one, right? Not this way, dude. The other way. Yeah, there you go. Put it down here because I want it to sink into the left side. And again, a little bit of dirt, but not too much. And now it's floating on the right side. So, of course, now I need to stack it up. Since I haven't used a junk wall yet on this one, I'm pretty sure I'm going to grab a junk wall. Because junk walls are real nice for texturing, especially when you put them with the support sticking out, you know? Which reminds me. When you're building fences, okay, you know, like surrounding enclosures, and you don't want to use all junk walls, right? You want to mix it up with wood pieces and warehouse pieces and, you know, barn pieces or whatever. What you want to do is, instead of stacking a bunch of junk walls up on the outside, put one junk wall sticking out every two or three sections. That way you get the illusion of supports, right? Because you can see the struts sticking out, but they're not the entire wall. So it looks flimsier, but it still looks sturdy enough to be convincing. I don't know if that makes any sense. But try it. Just put down like a wood wall and then a barn wall and then a junk wall in that order. Like every third one, put a junk wall. And then look at it. And it looks like it's sort of flimsy, you know, like it's being held up by some sort of magic. Now this thing didn't snap because the junk wall's already in there. And rather than take the junk wall out, I'm just going to group select it in as best I can. It's like, well, we'll see if I can get it closed. And if not, well, who cares? It's good enough. It's junky. It's scrappy. So take that out, put that in, take this back out, stick it back in, push it down, slide it as far as I can, and there we go. Now, since it's elevated on the left-hand side, they can get in this way. So now I'm going to go ahead and furnish it. Stick these things in there, a couple of beds, a chair, some random piece of furniture as a decoration, maybe a rug, and there you go. So when you're doing your build and you need something to fill a hole, right? Just take 10, 15 minutes and group select a bunch of crap in there. Just drop it on there and go, okay. Because I mean, it makes sense to me that there would be crappier shacks like this. Now here's the fun part. I forgot all my rules about chairs and I'm like, yep, drop it, pop, up it goes. Nope, ain't gonna work. The key to having stuff drop is to make sure the rug is flat on the floor below it, which I had forgotten completely when I was doing this. That ain't gonna work because they won't sit in it. So I gotta move it again. I have the worst time figuring out which angle I need to put the thing on the rug to get the rug to drop in the spot I need it to have the piece face the way I want it. Ah, and there it is. So there we go. Another piece of decoration here. An ashtray's good. Ashtrays are always nice spillers. Or, you know, that little rocket trash can's a good one. Got a lantern. They're gonna need a table to put their stuff on. This is my favorite table. I use this too much, I know, but it's small, it's regular, it's easy to place. And then we need a rug, but I don't want a typical rug because I used the flower rug in the last one. So let's get them a rubber mat. Why not? Will rubber mat go in? Yeah, that's good. And there we go. So there's our shack. There's the third crab shack. And we'll do a little tour around the outside. So I hope this is useful. I hope this is interesting. Gives you some ideas, some inspiration. I don't know. It's a good way to put up really crappy houses in a hurry. And be your own personal Commonwealth slumlord. And I want to thank y'all very much for watching and subscribing. I'll see you in the next one. Take care.